Hey, what is going on, everyone? Just here to bring you guys a bit of an update to my previous Lady Deathstrike event video. Now that we have had the store reset and we have the event store live, we also know the maximum amount of points that you need for the milestone, which actually isn't too far off from my predictions that I made in my video. So we're going to go over that. We're going to go over my suggestions for what you should buy in the event store, also how many Lady Deathstrike shards you can get, and whether or not we'll be able to get the Venom skin, the Ancient Pharaoh skin for Venom, all of that and more in this update. So let's get started here. I do want to draw your guys' attention to this. This was my my spreadsheet that you guys might have seen if you guys watched my previous video. And there was a few things that I was a bit off of. I actually kind of guessed, because I didn't know what the total points required for the milestone was. I suggested that it was going to be 5,000. It turns out that the total required points for the milestone is 3,500. So that's great. It's actually less than what I thought it would be. And so what that means is this scenario 3 doesn't matter at all, because that's actually way more work than I thought that than you actually need to do for this event. But what it does mean is actually it's pretty close to the scenario 2 from my event video, and that's great, because that means it's kind of the average amount of work that I kind of assumed that you'd need to do. So for this, you can see that my total points calculated for this is around 3,400. You're gonna have to do like one more thing on this list, but you know, basically 3 arena attacks daily, 14 raid attacks, which is 7 over both of the raids, and 4 blitz sim rotations, assuming that you got all of the characters available and unlocked. If you don't have all the characters unlocked, you may have to do a little bit more of all of this, either in the arenas, raid attacks, or in blitz sim rotations, in order to get that score for the 3,500. And so I just wanted to bring that up really quickly. I'm kind of happy that I wasn't too far off the mark. But I want to talk about the actual milestone itself. Let's take a look in game here and take a look at what we got. I've actually almost 9 hours in. I'm doing this video late at night here. But we're about 7 hours into the event. And I've actually almost cleared this already. So a lot of this was through, I think I've done 2 or 3 blitz sim rotations. I've done my raid attacks for the day, and I did about 3 or 4 arena attacks, and that got me to this. And actually, in terms of what's available in the milestone, it's actually not too bad. I believe it's a total of 2,500 silver phase bits, and we'll talk about that more once we go into the later part of the video. And there's a total of 12,000 mini candy up for grabs. Now, over the course of 10 days, that is 25,000 silver phase bits for the Venom costume, which is likely not enough. I say that because it's not quite in the store yet for some reason, and you get about 12,000 mini candy, and over the course of the 10 days, that is 120,000 mini candy. And we're going to talk about that a little bit more, because I built myself a little bit of a small spreadsheet with relation to that. But otherwise, in terms of the event rewards, we get some blue stuff, not all that important. We get 5 Lady Deathstrike shards. So if you fully clear all of the milestones here, you're only going to get 50 over the course of the 10 days, which means if you want to unlock her, you have to get at least 50 more shards out of the event store. Now, that's not going to be a problem at all, because when we look at the math, actually things look pretty good. There are some orange SBCs. That's not really all that important. Actually, what's nice is some of the teal gear. I've already claimed a little bit of that. I think it's all mutant related. Mutant and tech. So it's not too bad here. We do see some mutant, that's bio, I don't know what I was thinking. There are some of these teal mini uniques, I guess they're called, and some other ones here, and some other ones here. So these are the teal mini uniques, and I guess some standard, no, they're all mini uniques. I don't know what I'm talking about. Anyways, it's all teal mini uniques here. But in terms of the store, I've already just started to buy a little bit of, and we get all these ads, of course, popping up. I've already started buying some of the Lady Deathstrike shards in the store here. Now, I want to draw your attention really quickly to my other spreadsheet that I made. Very quickly, we're going to go over it together. So, basically, the total Lady Deathstrike shards from the milestones, I already said that, that's 50. So, total mini candy from the milestone, 120,000. That's 12K over 10 days. Sorry, 120,000 over 10 days. 12K per day is what I should have said. I don't know why. Let's change that really quick. And that means that you can get 5 Lady Deathstrike shards for 2,500 candy. Now, what that means is obviously over the course of that 120,000 candy that you could get, there is a total maximum possible shards from the store, 240. Now, this is if you spend all of your candy, max the milestone, and all of that goes towards Lady Deathstrike shards. you may have to actually refresh the store a few times as well, depending on when you're watching this video and things like that, in order to catch up or spend all your currency on time strictly on Lady Deathstrike shards. If that's what you're looking to do, then you may have to refresh a couple of times. I didn't do the math, but this is what I was told by a few other people. The total amount of possible Lady Deathstrike shards from the event in total, though, is the 240 plus the 50 equals 290. Now, that gets you awfully close to that 5-star. 5-star is 310 shards, which means you're 20 shards away from that 5-star. So how can you get that 5-star? Well, you could buy some more candy. I know that, you know, for some light spenders, you could do this. You would need to get about 20 more shards, which means you're gonna need about 10,000 more candy. So how would you get that? Well, you could buy this offer three times. This is in Canadian dollars, so it's probably about $5. I guess that's $15. Not super great value, I don't think. Other things that you could do is if you go into the Lady Deathstrike orb, if you want to spend some power cores, you could buy the Tough as Nails orb for 675 power cores. You know, depending on if you get lucky or not, this could be two or three orbs. You know, six is the bare minimum. So if you really, really want to squeeze out that 5-star because you got 5 red or something, you pull that, then that's great. You could do this if you want to. For me personally, I only pulled a 4 red star, so I'm probably just going to go for the 4-star, and then I'm going to buy some other stuff. I think that's what I'm probably going to do. I haven't decided if I'm going to buy the Venom skin or not. On the fence about that. It is a skin, but I kind of want it. I don't know yet. But anyways, if you just want a 4-star, then what you need to do is you obviously need to finish the milestone, which gives you 50 shards, and then 130 here from the store, which is a total of 65,000 candy, or, you know, just over half of what you get from the entire event. This leaves you with 55,000 candy. So what can you do that, and what in the store can you do with what's left over? Well, obviously there are the silver bits. You know, just to go back into the store myself, you can get the silver bits. That's 2,000 for 2,000 candy here. You can also get one augmented unique for 2,500 candy. Again, for me it's the augmented shield tech gear, but you know, this is gonna be random every time the store refreshes. You can also get two superior G13 uniques for 1500 candy, and once again, you know, you can see that here is the Focus Chi. Don't really want that. It seems to be only one unique slot, both for the orange and for the teal. Now, aside from that, you know, you can actually get some of this other teal stuff, but I personally don't know if I'd really buy it. Don't know if it's worth the price. That's going to be really up to you. I don't think I plan on buying these regular gear pieces. And definitely I would not do that for the orange or for the purple, because I think that it's just a bit of a waste of the currency. So what I would spend your currency on, you could, you know, if you see some Miasma or some really, really important G13 uniques in here, you could go for that if you feel that's a value. That's 750 candy per superior unique. Otherwise, it's going to be 2,500 just for one teal. Now, in terms of the gold, I think you're actually getting the most value out of the gold ones, but I'm not entirely sure. I haven't done the gold calculations versus the supply store. I'm not sure if that really matters. But if you do want to spend the leftover 55,000 on silver phase bits, you know, that actually gets you another 55,000 silver phase bits, because it's like 1,000 for 1,000 the way it's calculated here. So like I said, you are going to get 25,000 silver phase bits over the course of the milestone. So the problem here is that we don't actually know what the Venom cost of the costume is. So based on previous events, I'm going to assume it's probably not more than... I'm kind of assuming it's 50k, but it could be as high as 70k. I thought that one of the events was either like 65 or 70k bits for the event, so it's not going to exceed that amount. So the 25k that you get from the milestone, plus a total of potentially 55k from the store if you spent 55k on the bits, and then the other 65k on Lady Deathstrike to get that 4-star, then that would give you a total of 80,000 bits, which I don't see the Venom costume being more than that. So it's really up to you whether or not you're going to want to spend the remaining bits that you have, unless you're going all in on Lady Deathstrike, and that's going to be entirely up to you. That's your decision to do. But otherwise, it's going to be whether or not you want the Venom costume or not. Do you care about the Ancient Pharaoh Venom costume? Or do you want to get it on some, you know, teal uniques, the teal superior, whatever you want to call them, these uniques, the teal uniques, or do you want the superior uniques for the oranges? That's going to be entirely up to you. I might do a mix of both. If I see Miasma, I'll probably buy it, just because I still need my asthma to get Kitty Pride up further for my Doom Raid. If I see some maybe augmented miasma, maybe some really important uniques, I might buy that. But I am not committed to a 5-star Lady Deathstrike. I'm only committed to about a 4-star. It is a war team. I don't care too much. I'm not going hard on this team, and that's where I'm basically at in terms of this event. Overall, though, I actually think that this event impressed me a little bit more than I expected. I went into this thinking that it was going to be kind of crap on the back of the Weapon X Wolverine milestone. I wasn't expecting much. I knew that the costumes for both Wolverine and for Emma Frost has been pay to play or pay to win, or whatever you want to call it. Anyways, that it wasn't free to play friendly. This event actually is fairly free to play friendly. I'm thinking of events like Moondragon, like Moon Knight. Both of them had the moon in their name, actually. But, you know, I was only able to get them to about 4-star free-to-play. So Lady Deathstrike, I can easily get 4-star and pretty close to 5-star free-to-play if I so desire. You know, I could get that 5-star free-to-play if I wanted to via the cores, but I'm not going to because I'm going to save it for other things. So all in all, I think this is a really good event. Could they have done better? Of course. But I do actually like the way that the scoring is as well, and I have to kind of point that out as well. The fact that we don't really need to use the traded characters other than Blitz, we no longer have to do it in raids, we don't have to do it in arena, we don't have to do it in war. Actually, we don't even get any score for war, so that's great, because I don't really care too much about that. And a lot of this is stuff that you're going to be doing anyway, so I'm not overly bothered by this. Overall, I actually give this event a 8 or a 9 out of 10. That's actually how good I think this event is. The only other better events, of course, are things like the anniversary events, where you get, you know, the free elite 5s, 6s, those kind of things. But, you know, all in all, I actually think this is a very positive event. And I know that's rare to say, right? I can't remember the last time that I praised these guys, but I have to say this was actually a pretty decent event. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. What are you gonna do with your mini candy? Are you gonna go for the 4-star Deathstrike? Are you gonna go for the 5-star Deathstrike? What are your plans? Where are you gonna spend your currency? I just wanted to let you guys know what's going on and what I plan to do with myself. And I hope that this helps, and I hope that my previous video helped as well to get you guys prepared for what to do in this event. Of course, until next time, and probably my blog posters will be my next video. Stay safe and healthy, and I'll see y'all later. Boilon signing out.